Bob T. Hick is going to be on. So there's a lot of good music coming up. So I hope you hang around. And we're not gonna let ourselves get blown away here, are we, guys? So we're not gonna let ourselves get blown away here, are we? Yes. Okay. Please welcome the regulars.
Thank you.
and a caterpillar.
Wanting to tell you within these lines the thoughts that lie within my mind. But my pen reaches paper and reacts to fear, and all I write is disgrace, and I wish you were here. I write about the circle skies as the evening of my summer dies. I write about the things I see but understand. I'm in misery, wishing and hoping. I wanna write, I need you, but I write about vision. Don't you know that I wanna write more like I need you now? More than ever before. Just why you call, and I'm wondering if you're missing me at all. We're so far apart, and I wanna be together. I wanna say what really matters, but I'm worried about the weather. Don't you know that I wanna write more like I need you now, more than ever before. kitchen and home, hoping and wishing. I wanna write, I need you, but I write about vision. Don't you know that I wanna write more like I need you now, more than ever before? Well, we're so far apart, and I wanna be together. I wanna say what really matters, but I write about the weather. Don't you know that I wanna write?
Play with golf balls.
Love is too small a word.
just for my brother, because he's right here. We're going to play out of tune.
Thank you.
This is a song by Lenny Kravitz. It's called Rosemary.
Not to the beat, if you're hard.
where it was a plane load of deportees, immigrants being taken back to Mexico. And what do you guys hear? It's a song. We actually do it. It's called Deportee. Upstairs.
Hi there.
Bye.
Howdy.
Mercedes on camera.
Jim's Mercedes. Pretty, isn't it?
Okay. Not going nowhere.
As you know, Ann and Andrew, your father and I have wills dated January 1st of 1972, and the past weekend I've been working on trying to update mine so that it's more current with what we need for today. The will, I'm going to make a couple of copies. One will be left here, and hopefully I'll have time to put one in the safe deposit box, because the original, I think, is still in an attorney's office in Washington, D.C., but his name is on the will, so you'll know who that is. But basically, our attorney is Edward Lippert, who is located on Little River Turnpike in Annandale. And as you know, his phone number is in our little gray directory, and he would be the person that you need to contact in the event that something happened to both of us. Because Dad and I are getting ready to take a plane trip in the next couple of days to Arizona, there is that possibility, obviously, that both of us could be killed in an accident or in a car accident there or something. So we felt that it was important that you know who to contact. And again, you know, that would be Ed Lippert. And he would be the one that could legally advise you on what you're to do. Because Andrew is still under the age of 18, I indicated in the will that I would ask that Kurt Rohr, my brother, and you, Ann, be co-guardians of Andrew until he reaches legal age. But I did list in the will that he have the option of living in the city or county or state of his choosing. and I would hope that you would honor that. Our safe deposit key is, as you know, in the little drawer of the coffee grinder on the shelf. You would need that to get into the safe deposit box. That's where one copy of the will that was drawn up in June of 1972 is. But again, bear in mind that this is a supplement that will be attached to that will, and there are some changes on there. And the supplement is what I would certainly want to have honored. I indicated that I would want any real estate that we hold, and presently, as you know, that would include our house on Stone Mansion Court and the townhouse in Sequoia, and that the real estate be sold within a 2-year time frame, and then that money would go into a trust fund for you and Andrew, and you would be getting the interest from any investments as required for your education or your personal needs. You would not get the bulk of the estate until the age of 28. And any personal items, as I had indicated in the will, that you and Andrew would want, we would want you to have the freedom to be able to select whatever you wanted. And anything that you didn't want, again, you could give immediate members like Kurt and the nieces and nephew any chance to perhaps pick something in the way of a memento that they might wish. The rest of the stuff, if there are things, of course, that you wouldn't want, such as the furniture, etc., then we would expect that you would sell that. And again, that would go into the trust fund. Bear in mind, too, that the plane tickets were charged to our Visa first card, gold card, and there is insurance on those automatically, that in the event that we would be in an accident with the airplane, it will pay to the beneficiary a certain sum of money. I think it's in the neighborhood of like $150,000 per person, but I'm not sure on that. Also, in the event that there would be, for instance, a plane crash, the airlines always has a settlement afterward, and it's usually settled out of court. And it's usually, particularly like in your case where you would be losing both parents, that would probably be a substantial amount. Here again, you would need to contact Ed Lippert so that you would have an attorney settling and handling everything for you. I don't know what his fee would be, that you would have to find out ahead of time from him. Sometimes they take a third of whatever the final settlement is. That too, that settlement should also go into the trust for you and Andrew. You probably noticed that we just purchased some bathroom fixtures to be put in the bathroom that Dad usually uses, and again, in the event something happened, you know, call Russell Lingefeld. His name is in the little gray directory, and have him take care of that. And any kind of fix-up that would be required in the house, we would want that done before the house went on the market. You would probably have to rely on a certain amount of advice and guidance from Kurt and Marilyn. They're used to owning real estate. She, obviously being an official in a bank, knows quite a bit about wills and how to handle finances. And I think that they would be a good guide for you, as well as Mr. Lippert. Lyle, what do you want to add to that?
Go.
There are several benefits that Ann and Andrew would get from the House of Representatives, through the House of Representatives, upon my death. There is about $320,000 worth of term life insurance. There would be a death payment for a 20-year employee of the House, which would be the equivalent of 1 year's salary. And there also would be the disposal of the retirement fund. And to determine what all those things are worth, you should contact Dave Obey, and he will take care of getting you in touch with the clerk of the House to get it all straightened out. There are also some other life insurance policies. There are three equitable life insurance policies on my life. They were for $10,000 each, but since they're paid up, the face amount will be a little less than that. There's a $25,000 First Colony life insurance policy, and a policy from a Midland National Life in Sioux Falls, which is, I think only the face amount is only $1,000, but there's been additional paid up insurance, so that would be a little bit more than that.
Okay, and I guess I should mention that there was a equitable life insurance policy on my life for $25,000. And that has been, I think since 1977 we've had that. So you would want to contact perhaps, would they need to contact Prairie Lewis about that?
Yeah, probably we should have the policies. But
the policies are up in the closet on the shelf in a great big blue plastic folder, and I think all of the policies are in there. We've also got a metal file in the closet, and you would need to go through that because there are some things in there. You would eventually have to make the decision on what you wanted to do with a lot of the things that you might figure have sentimental value. You know, there are certain things in the house of grandpa and grandma's, and if there was something that you decided you didn't want, rather than to sell it, certainly give Kurt the option of having some of it, and maybe Mary, since Claire is no longer around, she should have a chance to perhaps have a few things if it was something that you didn't want.
Well, Daryl and Jody too.
Well, I was speaking primarily of stuff that had been, you know, my mother and dad's is what I'm talking about right now. The main thing is you have to remember that if you were faced with dissolving a lot of these things, it would be quite a task, and you have to give yourself ample time, which is why in the will I said 2 years. By the end of 2 years that the real estate should be sold. I would hope that you could sell it sooner than that, but certainly give yourself ample time so that you can make some decisions about things, because there would be an awfully lot, and you can't just start putting things in storage and then pay indefinitely for the stuff in storage. I know you had asked before about whether it would be all right to rent out the house. Currently, the Sequoia townhouse is rented, and you could certainly keep that rentable for a while if you wish. I don't really recommend that you rent this house because of the fact that we've got the pool in the back, and as I said before to you, I think that could create some problems, and you would almost have to talk to Ed Lippert about working out the legal aspects of that, and I don't think it would be worth your while. I think it would give you more grief than what you'd want. I think it would be better.
But if you didn't live in the house, it would probably be better to rent it than to let it sit empty.
Yeah. you know, that's one thing too. You might decide that you wanted to live in it. In the event that something happened right now, you would probably even have to take some time off from school, because until you could be making some decisions on what you wanted to do. That's all I can think of for now. If I think of something else, we'll put a supplement to this.
Do you want your baby to have your eyes, your smile, your crack habit? It could happen. When a woman does crack during pregnancy, so does her unborn baby. And that can cause addiction, brain damage, and birth defects if the baby lives. But that won't happen to your baby if you don't do crack. The more you care about your baby, the more you have to care about yourself.
Why I'm calling. I'm moving out and I want my deposit back. I'm not kidding, Steve. You meet me in the lobby at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. I don't want any.
Tables look so small.
Yeah, they trying to come down on the ATM and
speak. Stop it, Andrew.
We're smart. Now, I'm
going to
get the way I stop that.
Hi.
For that dude you want. It's for
the ball.
But the radio station.
The hot water heater has been off for like 9 hours. And what?
Busted in the washer.
Again? Yeah. Damn. If you want to go, we can.
Watch, Mike. It's a pain.
Okay. Yeah. See the graveyard? Uh-huh. Look out in front of us too. This one over here, the red, that's pretty too. Oh, the castle one. That's pretty. See the guy waving?
And the end of every trip. And that they went right back to their, oh God, I'm
yeah.
So upset. I mean, I knew that, but God, I'm so, poor me.
I thought you
Robin
would, I thought you'd really want to see this is, here's how they do
official
it.
Official acceptance to Virginia Tech. I'm gonna forget it.
Why are you
gonna
forget?
Forget.
Why would you forget?
I don't talk to you.
Andrew John Stitt. That's so funny the way it looks written out, you know?
Nightstand in the middle, but they were such comfortable beds, and I mean, we just both were so comfortable.
Okay, Mike.
Yeah.
Doesn't it seem to always look like this when we come
yes,
in here?
Yes, because that's industry for you. Oh. There's so much industry involved. It's such, it gets so dirty.
I would never want to live here.
I hate both.
Thank you.
majestic mammoth relatives from the ocean.
Are Steve and Doug. Today we're going to explore some of the special abilities of whales and dolphins, including how they use sound to communicate and define things in the water. Our large video screens allow us to add some fun educational pieces during the presentation.
Thank you. your support to help make these changes. You hope that by coming here and seeing the dolphins and the whales, you'll leave here with better understanding and appreciation of one of the ocean's magnificent creatures. And certainly when you leave tonight, you'll start to think about what part you can play in the conservation of our oceans.
Don't get me wrong, you shower with a fine woman, but people who need running buttoned out.
I hope this is good. I don't know when I've ever baked a cake, ever.
That's not me. That's not me either.
Simon.
Ah? There you are. And you're going to be our neighbors who have a washer and dryer.
Just leave the quarter on the mat.
Happy 72. Oh, shit. 27. I saw that. That's that guy comedian.
I didn't even see it, you.
Thanks, guys.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
That's awesome.
What, no kiss?
Do I have to kiss her again?
Mike, do you want a kiss?
Oh, gosh, yeah.
That's awesome.
Okay, now that we had happy birthday napkins, but for some reason the beer spit all over them. So what happened?
Just calories? Suck on your napkin.
There you go.
Yeah, just suck on the napkin. Here, I'll get another. Forks.
Forks, yeah. Drawer under the microwave.
That is awesome. Much as I try and avoid birthdays.
Why?
You do?
27 now. I have to.
27.
That age, you know, you gotta
relive it over and over and over and over.
I'm having a birthday.
There you go. Oh, we need a knife, don't we?
I'm gonna wash this later too.
Sure.
Now that you're 27, what are your goals in life?
And who are they with?
Here. So the cake. Goals? Whoa. Yeah, we saw goals.
What kind is it, chocolate?
It's chocolate. Yeah. I want to get chocolate, and then before I left, I looked in the cupboard, and I saw the yellow, and I'm like, well, I can't get chocolate frosting, anyone won't see it.
There.
But if you like cake, I have to leave some of this. We'll never eat it all.
Uh-oh. Crash diet.
What happened?
That's when the diet crashes. Thank you.
Happy Easter, Mikey.
Okay.
This is it.
You know, I thought I ordered that, but they did. I don't think I did. Sneaky, cool. Aren't we?
Ooh. You got a nice big bet.
I got a big one. Speaking of which, I hurt myself at work yesterday.
You're kidding.
Banged up my leg, yeah.
Oh, what is this with the legs?
Oh,
it's
it
just
hurts
a sit,
so
people.
Good.
I'm okay.
Feel
of them.
Oh,
yeah, mine was kind
of
easy to
I tripped over one of those shoe things.
Oh, yeah.
We were so busy, and everybody's like, are you okay? I'm like, when I went in the back then, I rolled up my leg. This whole part was red. I'm like,
oh, God.
But that's the worst part.
When I got down, I just, like, sat down for a while and tried to rest, and it didn't stop hurting. And I couldn't find Russell or anybody, so I just kind of, like, hobbled over to the ski patrol place, and nobody was in there. But
said
if you need assistance, call for extension 503 or something.
Yeah,
so
if you're
like,
hanging there,
I was like, help.
Thank you.
welcome to figure out Jeff.
All the glass in there, all the papers flew out of the glove compartment. Luckily, we were both wearing sunglasses, so we didn't get any glass in our eyes.
Lit in years, because I remember we lit them one time when we had just two candlesticks.
He didn't get
there,
the station back on, did he?
Yes. Station.
See, that looks pretty lit, doesn't it? Should light this more often.
It will.
Well,
haven't you ever seen in old houses where
there's
not enough light on it?
Serious?
He's sitting against the back blind.
Doesn't that camera work?
Well, I think that looks very nice.
Okay, where do we start?
Well, gee whiz, Ann and Andrew always get to do the distribution. Does that, I bet that hat keeps your head warm, right? Let me give it a try.
It's recording now.
A tape, right? Oh.
Before
terrific.
The CD player got booed up, yeah.
Oh, one is Ocean Surf, and what is this?
Mountain Retreat.
And then flip them over, there's
retreat.
Two more on the other sides, too.
And there's Country Stream and Rainforest.
Is that what I'm going in on?
Neat.
No.
I'm anxious to hear them.
One of their presents.
Oh, gosh,
going
yeah,
in
they're
on,
really neat.
So. Huh?
You put them on, and you just listen to them. It sounds like you're out.
$150. Stop by and hear how Hurley's.
Can I chill?
What I just had?
Yeah, I
got it. I had some cookie dough.
Bad.
Good.
I think going over to my parents is a bad idea.
Oh.
Because I'm getting, feel like I'm getting sick.
Why did you get sick? Because you went over there?
Yeah, it says.
Your mom is sick.
God, I hope I didn't get it after just an hour. Right?
What, does your mom have a cold?
I didn't get it. I know I didn't. There's I didn't.
So you throw fish?
Yeah, I throw fish. We'll see if my fly butt.
It's called Original Connection by SJC, handcrafted with the highest quality manufacturing standards.
It's only
New York,
this is not
Paris,
a music
London,
video.
And Milan.
You do not work for MTV.
Look at, these that even go with what I got on.
A little bit. A little bit more turquoise.
What'd they get to Lyle?
Great quotes from great leaders.
Oh, she always comes up with some neat ideas for books for you. Thank you, Mary and Joe.
Thank you so much.
Anyone who stops learning is old, whether at 20 or 80. Anyone who keeps learning stays young. The greatest thing in life is to keep your mind going.
That's Symphony by I want to be on it. I should say. Oh my God, more earrings. Casablanca. Isn't that cute? Henderson's gonna make me some of her
beading ones.
She really
and Anna,
you look
like who?
Norton. No, put the flip down. Andrew, Lyle,
on
put the
honeymooners.
That is. I don't think that's too small.
Yes,
oh,
it is,
come
Mom.
On.
He pulls down over.
Oh, come on.
It hardly. Look at that.
It isn't even.
Well,
so,
if you see the large, it came down over his ears.
It isn't even
maybe
sitting.
Maybe they make a medium.
This isn't even sitting on my head.
Yeah, you can tell.
I mean, I go out in
and
about a 3.5 mile an hour wind and go,
I think they're all. See, I should have had you try it on after I got it exchanged. I took the large back, got him this size, and I thought, well, now this one's going to fit. Should have had you try it on because I don't think they're going to have any left.
Too bad.
Happy fun ball. Do not taunt it.
Do not
happy fun ball. It's made of an unknown substance that fell to earth.
An unknown glowing substance.
It is illegal in some states.
You might want to turn down the radio. Because like the radio will come on real loud for this.
Well, the music's coming back on, so.
Want me a ham?
Hey,
partially
right.
Boneless. Hey. Spiral sliced.
Don't turn it upside down.
Okay.
Yeah, as long as there's music on it, it should sound okay.
Where's the knife?
Where's the knife?
What happened to the knife?
Probably
oh, maybe I've still got it.
Fell down in my shoes or something.
Wait, I think I still got it.
I'll put my shoe on.
Probably sitting on it. No? Oh, there it is.
I took my shoes off at work because my feet were so tired.
And everybody hit a fit.
No, guess what was in there when I put them back on?
One of those sensor pins.
Ow! Really?
Yep.
So you do that on purpose?
Those things that they pin on the clothes.
Oh, yeah.
Sharp pins.
Did you say they gave... There was a little loose one in the bathroom the other day, and I felt it on my foot. They really do smart. Did you say they gave you a 15-minute break at work?
No.
When did you get to take lunch, and how much time did you get
for an hour.
Oh, and that's the only break you get?
To my baby brother.
I guess that's right. They have to, you work 4 hours, isn't it, and they have to give you
I guess
you
they do have to let you eat
break.
These days.
That's the law.
What's that?
These are the Christmas cards I sent. Oh my
Somebody
God.
Told me it was.
Dear Andy, this is a little college care package. I'm so glad you're doing well and having fun at JMU. Mike and I look forward to coming down and seeing you again. Merry Christmas, Anna.
Isn't that special?
How are you related to me again?
You're her baby brother.
Okay.
He will always be her baby
okay.
brother.
Okay. Our college care.
Oh.
Everything. That's awesome. A bath sponge.
Little
and a toothbrush.
Sponge.
I do need another pen. I do need another pen. I can always use peanut butter tandy cake. And I did need some more shampoo. And finally, oh cool, I've got a little wire thing to tote it around in because my other one's like all.
What's the name of this one?
Wenceslas Square.
Oh, yeah.
It's about Czechoslovakia after the Prague Spring. It's really interesting, actually. It's about this professor who wrote a book about the arts in Czechoslovakia during the Prague Spring when they, there was like a certain time, it was like from 1968 to, or like from 1965 to 68 when under Dubček was the prime minister of Czechoslovakia.
Yeah.
And even though it was under Russian rule, there was still a freedom for a while and the arts, works and theater was a central part of everyone's lives. And then the Russians decided that they were getting too free, so they brought in tanks and they killed the little sprouts that had grown up from the concrete of Russian rule. And so then and this professor came in 1968 when they had just done that, but still like the arts were kind of the underground way for people to get together and meet even though they were being oppressed. And then the professor goes back in 1974 to do a kind of Where Are They Now chapter and finds out that all these people are either dead or missing or escaped out of the country or have, like, you know, become forbidden or are doing, like, TV commercials instead of great theater. And so that's what it's about. And it, even though the main character is supposed to be a male, Rachel's going to play the professor.
That would be a stretch.
And Costa.
Oh, that's cute.
It still plays that Colby one. You can chat.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
but this
wow.
is like
small. Yeah.
It's pretty sophisticated there.
Sure is.
That's pretty.
That is a neat mug.
Says what it is.
Our mug design is taken from a 1914 pen and ink drawing in the University Museum Archives by museum artist Mary Louise Baker. It shows a panel from an Attic Greek red figured amphora. 510 from 520 to 510 BC in the museum's Mediterranean section.
University of Pennsylvania.
Oh, yeah.
Which, you know,
the
Amherst Museum.
Close enough.
Let me see it. Andrew?
Oh, wow.
Let me
see it.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Aren't those neat?
Those are gorgeous.
Beautiful.
Oh,
that's cute.
Yeah, now there's one other one, and I'm going to show you the other one, and then you can decide if you like the other one
you
better.
Hang it on the door.
Now, this one, doesn't have magnets on the back. It's got stickies, and I wouldn't recommend you put those on. Well, I don't know how
it's
much it's going to leave a residue.
But
I thought what you might want to do is, since it's an erasable thing, if you don't want to leave it for door messages, you could also put it on your refrigerator when you want to write temporary
yeah,
things that you want. Oh, you have? Oh, okay. So then you might want to put that on the door. This is
yeah.
Andrew's.
You're still taping, dude. You're still taping.
Candy.
Minimal.
Honey, I
don't spend a lot of time on these. Work.
Right.
That's nice.
That. Now this is for Chuck. He got me a cup.
See my mom.
He always showed me.
But I let them open the door and I said,
We will have a coffee cup.
Hold up. This is to me. Lord, I'm afraid to open gifts from the boys. That's where I am. No, you have to live with them to appreciate them.
I bet.
We've lived with one of them for a while.
A little while.
Hold up. Oh. Or a knife or something?
Got it. My Christmas stamp t-shirt.
Alrighty.
That goes with my sweatshirt.
Good, you can sleep in them.
A t-shirt?
That's cute.
Mm-hmm. I like that one.
That's who needed the other one. I'll just send it over. I'm not losing my mind.
No, everybody's put it back in. Be good for us to get some fun.
Wow. That
was from Daddy and Eileen.
Wow.
Yeah, it'll make you drowsy.
Thank you. Nice. You are.
Did you hear about Nick Nolte? Yeah, a test of contact. She said that's the gift that keeps on giving.
I'll show you an article in the paper. It's a scream.
She said, "My mother's ever said, well, I guess it's John. It's the
joy.
Oh, birthday. I'm a baby. He was tired.
So let me take all your gifts."
Nick Nolte, did you read about him in the paper? This is, I mean, the funniest thing I've ever read.
I think she's warm enough here. You want to lay down on the couch?
No, he said he would come over.
I'm going to put the
headband in there.
Hey, Charlie.
The second one.
Look how big they are. Wow. Like a storyboard.
Oh, I'm upside down.
You just
I'm
found
standing
that out.
On my head.
Handstand.
All right. Am I hot or what?
Oh, it's like a quilt. Cool. Yeah. I'll wait till we get a camera to bring that up.
You can get through life like that.
I'm gonna try.
No.
We hit that
man.
Come here, Chow. Come on, baby.
She's not a baby.
Yes, she is.
She's not.
Come on, come open your presents.
Yes.
We're gonna get some film and some batteries. Here, chill. This is what you told me about.
I just got the letter. Out of 875 finalists, yeah, you need a good grade film to start with.
Merry Christmas.
I'm always blown up.
Can I pass this around?
Our apartment burned down. Everything.
climbing chest. Here.
You can't stop it. You need some help, babe. Now show me what. Go ahead. Go ahead, pumpkin.
You talk.
Talk about what?
Tell them what we're videotaping for.
You tell them.
Erin changed her hair color and she wants to see if she likes this color better. Because it doesn't show her roots anymore. All done?
You are the master of the master.
A woman. A